What is up, everybody, and welcome back to another episode of Tattoo Critiques. I'm Pony Lawson, and what we like to do here is talk about your tattoos. Whether you're an artist, collector, we like to talk about them all.
Somebody order a large tattoo critique?
And don't forget to stick around to the very end where we talk about my favorite tattoo of the episode, as well as a featured artist who I think you guys should keep an eye on. So let's play some music and then we'll talk about some tattoos. So the first one sent in is from Arda. And Arda, you sent in this very cool Baby Yoda. Right off the bat, I love this tattoo. I think this is very cool.
Baby Yoda!
So I've just been informed by my producers that he actually has a name, and it is Grogu, not Baby Yoda. So the texture that you have running through this tattoo really, really works here. I do wish, however, that you had some smooth shading in here as well, around the ears and things like that on the inside of the ears, just because I feel like you've got a lot of stippling and a lot of fur texture going on and not so much of that smooth texture to give it a nice contrast. I kind of wish you threw a small liner around the hand that's sitting out in front because it kind of gets lost a little bit in the shirt collar and a little bit in the ear and things like that. If you were to just introduce a little bit of a liner to that hand, I think it would help sit forward a little bit from the rest of the tattoo, making it seem like it's actually, you know, in front of everything. I think you chose a great reference for this tattoo as well. I've seen a ton of references for Baby Yoda or Grogu. I just like how you can see everything in here and nothing's hidden by his little pod or whatever he lives in. I was just waiting for Josh to correct me. I do love the whites that you introduced in this tattoo. I do wish these outlines were a bit stronger on the top part of the head where it looks a little furry. It's not bad where it sits, but I just wish it was a little more crisp. Also along the bottom of the tattoo as well, it kind of just seems like you were relying on the stipple shading to carry the line through, whereas I would have used a thin liner, a three liner, something like that, just to make sure that that bottom line is crisp as well. Do the same thing that you used for the outside of those sleeves. Overall, solid tattoo. This is a very fun one to look at and a very cool looking tattoo in general. Just a few things I would work on, you know, the strength of lines and things like that. Don't be afraid to use small liners, a single liner, even a three bug pin liner. You did mention that you used a three round liner for this entire tattoo. I just wish you would have used it in a couple more spots, you know, like the hand and the bottom of the shirt, things like that. So thank you very much, Arda, for sending that in. Very cool tattoo. Okay, the next tattoo is sent in from Samet from Turkey. And Samet, you sent in this beautiful black and white tattoo on an arm. I do wish, however, that it were an unfiltered photo to where I could see the actual color tones of the arm as well as the reds and things like that, you know, from the actual tattoo itself. But this is a very cool looking tattoo, like I said, overall. It's a tattoo that has a lot of elements to it. However, when we zoom in a little bit, that's when things start to fall apart. And what I mean by that is the line work and things like that, if we take our eyes to the top of the tattoo, to the eyeball, in the little circle, the circle seems to kind of get away from you, as well as the line work for the caduceus, the staff and snakes. It just seems a little weak. I'm not sure exactly how well these little words are gonna hold up over time, 5 to 10 years down the road. I just worry about them being so very small. It just seems like they're barely holding on, so I worry about them in the future. Again, I hate to keep bashing you about these lines, but if we go over to these little like atom and galaxy lines as well, it just seems like those lines aren't as strong as they should be either. You do have some very strong shading when it comes to the body or armor or whatever it is that figure is wearing. The shading on that figure is very smooth. It's just the outlines are holding you back quite a bit. So if we look at another tattoo that you sent in, again, the shading is spectacular. I think your strong suit is shading. When you look at these figures that are sitting back to back, I think that shading is on point. But when you look over to the lines, these nice, long, straight lines, I think you kind of lose it there. And I'm talking about the lines throughout this entire tattoo. They just don't seem that strong. It honestly looks like two different people are tattooing this. Going back to the circle in the middle of this one is a little wonky as well, and the circles off to the right. Again, these are just, this is just something that you really need to pay attention to and slow down. I know that the main meat of this tattoo is in those two soldiers, but you have to make sure that you're doing just as good of a job on the rest of the tattoo as you did on these two pieces of the tattoo. When you take a step back, the design and the tattoo itself looks great. They look like intricate designs, so they've got to be clean all the way through. These are the kind of things that's gonna sell people on these tattoos. So again, overall, this is a very cool design concept, and you've got some strong shading, but I do think you could work on your line work a bit, you know, your small lines, your thicker lines and things like that, and maybe set up some of these things in this tattoo to survive 10, 20, 30 years from now. So thank you, Samet, for sending those in. The next couple tattoos are sent in from Matej. Matej, you sent in this portrait of the singer Pink, which looks very cool. I love the design element about this. I love how you have a couple things peeking out of the frame as well. I do wish it were a softer shade in the background and not this stipply line work that you have. You want the texture to shine through the subject and not so much the background. You want her to be holding all the texture and the background to be very soft and smooth, because you don't want the background to be distracting from the actual subject matter. But I do love the hair shades and things like that that you have in this tattoo. Too, you can tell that you're not just like punching these in or going crazy with them, but you actually have a method to it. Another tattoo you sent in was this butterfly in the chest. Had to be very painful, I'm sure, right in the middle of the sternum. But again, this tattoo is very solid. I love the blacks that you have in this. They don't look weak by any means. They look very strong. Your outlines look strong. Even your very thin outlines that you have for the butterfly's antenna looks very strong. Again, this isn't a crazy tattoo by any means. There isn't any crazy shading or any crazy shadows or highlights or anything like that, but this is a very well done tattoo. The darks to the lights, back to the dark again. It's just a good overall balance. After reviewing your work, I can tell that you really like to work in a lot of liners, but I think you would benefit from introducing some mags to your work as well. Like I said, the background of that pink tattoo would greatly benefit from maybe like an 11 curve mag or 13 curve mag, something like that, just to give it some nice soft shading. Thank you very much, Matej. Keep up the good work. Okay, next up is Aireial Morris. Aireial, you sent in this, what looks to be a woman's face on top of some sort of pedestal. I'm just not sure what it is. To me, it kind of looks like a candlestick or a pawn or something like that. Again, I'm just not sure. I'm trying to find something to talk about. The hair looks to be done well. There is something intriguing about this tattoo. When you first look at it, you know, the design kind of pops and, you know, it looks good. Like I said, I do love the lines that you have through the hair and the little lines that you have coming off the hair as well. I guess I would have liked to seen it with a mag shade coming off the cheeks instead of that liner. I don't hate the liner shades. I would just be curious to see what it looks like had you taken a mag and give this some nice soft shading throughout. The stand at the bottom isn't super symmetrical, but other than that, like I said, the design is cool. There are just some things here and there that I would work on. So thanks, Aireial, for sending that in. I appreciate you. All right, so the next tattoo is sent in from Logan Ramsam. Logan, you sent in this, what I'm being told is a Jordan 1. So Logan, I would have liked to seen some mag shading in this tattoo. I do think your stippling effect works on a few things in this, like the laces and a couple other spots where texture could really work. However, I don't think it works as well on the outside of the shoe, you know, where the logo sits and all the rest of the leather or part of the shoe would be. I think it would have been beneficial to use a very soft shade from a mag, you know, a 13, 15, 17 mag, something like that, just to give it some smooth shading in that black area and the dark area. Again, just so we have some sort of contrast between the texture and the smooth parts of the shoe. It seems like the outline falls apart a little bit on the outside in some parts. It seems like you have 90% of it there, but there is a part on one of the laces where there's just no line. It's non-existent. I'm assuming that's an accident, as I don't know why there would be a part left open, but you know, it's nothing that can't be fixed going back in it. It does get a little messy in the laces. Like I said, I do like the texture that you have in there, but as far as the readability goes, it just gets a little messy where all those laces are meeting. Again, could be remedied through a liner, just making sure that you've got the borders of all these laces where they need to be and not leaving anything left open. Because even if something has a soft edge to it, it's still gonna be a line. Whether that's a one drop line, two drop line, there still needs to be something there to hold that edge. Up on the tongue, it's supposed to say Nike with a little swoosh underneath it. You do have the swoosh there, but not the Nike. It kind of seems like you wanted to leave the Nike in there, but didn't quite commit fully. I would have either left that out altogether or tried to fully commit and make that a readable Nike. Near the right side of the shoe, it kind of looks like you gave up on the stitching a little bit, because I do like the stitching effect that you have in this shoe, but there are some parts where it just disappears. For instance, this small section that's just to the right of the Nike swoosh symbol, it just seems like you left a lot of that stitching out and maybe didn't quite fully commit. There are a couple other places in the shoe that you did the same thing, you know, above the swoosh. There are some threading that just kind of seems to stop, disappear, and then continue on again. I think your biggest fear here is commitment, which I think some of us can relate to. But if you're gonna have stitching in part of this, you're gonna have to make sure to carry it all the way through. But Logan, as a whole, is a very cool tattoo to look at, very cool concept. Thank you for sending that in. So that's gonna be it for this week's critiques. But before we go, you know I gotta talk about my favorite of the episode, which was sent in by Arda. Arda, I picked yours this week for several reasons. This is just a very good tattoo overall. The minute you look at it, you kind of get a... The texture that you've got throughout his coat, the little white highlights, down to the reference. This checks all the boxes, so congratulations on being this week's favorite. And don't forget, if you guys want to send in your tattoos for me to critique, send them into ponycritiques@gmail.com, and hopefully we'll see them on a future episode. Don't forget to like, subscribe, share this video with all your friends, and hit that notification bell so you can be notified when we put up another video. And one more thing, let's not forget about the featured artist this week, which is going out to Pawel Indulski from Poland. Pawel has been a huge inspiration to me and my work over the past few years. You can actually see a lot of the way that he does things in his designs translate over to my work as well. I've definitely taken a few things here and there that he's done and implemented in my work because, like I said, I really look up to him and his work is impeccable. So don't forget to go over to his Instagram page, give him a follow, let him know I sent you, and yeah, we'll see y'all next week. Peace.